This is a Haystack Boiler. I'm Darren, and this is the Industrial Revolution. Haystack boilers were the first ever boilers used for steam engines. Back in the 1700s, if you wanted steam, this is what you used. They hung around for quite a while, even though they were actually really inefficient.
I'm willing to bet that you've never seen one of these Haystack boilers before. In fact, when I was searching for information online, the only photos were actually of this specific boiler. The reason's pretty simple. Although every early steam engine used something very much like this, these boilers are not really very good. They use a lot of fuel, they only produce low pressure steam, and not a lot of it. Finally, due to the low pressure, they could only really power atmospheric engines, not any of the newer types of steam engines. But they were easy to build, easy to understand. So this is where all steam boilers started. So let's take a look at how this boiler works. First, you have your fire box in the bottom. Yeah, you build your fire here, wood or coal, typically. Metal door there, acts as a flue as well, to control your air intake. And above it, you have a giant wrought iron sphere. The sphere is set into a massive brickwork. And if you look at where the fire is, it's at one side of the sphere. The brickwork is around it with the chimney at the back. Well, if you look inside here, what you see is that the brickwork directs the flue gases from the fire around the sphere and out the chimney. That allows you to recapture some of the heat that's in the flue gases. So you're not just heating with the fire, you're heating with the flue gases around the outside of this metal sphere. You have a drain valve here in the bottom, in case you ever have to actually drain this. An access hatch if you need to get inside. You have this water tank up at the top, which doesn't have to be very high, even though it's dropping water into the top of the boiler. That would allow you to add water to the boiler whenever you needed to. The operation is very simple. You light your fire. The fire gradually heats up the Haystack boiler. The boiler slowly builds up pressure up to, like I said, about 5 psi maximum. Then the steam goes out the top, and you refill it from the water tank here. The water tank, in this case, it's hooked up to the world's oldest steam engine, a Newcomen engine. And it actually was pumping water out of a mine that it wanted to get rid of, so it just pumped some of that water straight into here. Even back in the 1700s, when Haystack boilers were first created, safety was important. This valve up near the top of the boiler is a pressure relief valve. The weight could be adjusted to control the amount of pressure you'd allow to build up in the boiler. Since these boilers were such low pressure, they needed only a small weight.
So Haystack boilers like this aren't really very efficient. Later boiler designs ducted the flue gas through the boiler directly, initially with a single flue, later with multiple pipes, to recapture far more of the energy used. So they were inefficient for fuel, they were low pressure output, only about 5 psi, low steam output. So they're pretty much limited to just atmospheric engines. In fact, later when they got replaced, remember boilers don't last forever, when you replace the boilers, you'd actually replace them with something more efficient. Despite that fact, though, without Haystack boilers like this, steam engines would have never really gotten started. And that's why this is the Industrial Revolution.